Microservices tutorial series. So in this session I am going to discuss with the feature called load balancing. So load balancing in microservices is when there is a too much load to a particular microservice, it can be balanced by using Eureka ribbon module. In general, any computing services, whenever load balancing feature needs to be implemented, we can distribute the workloads across the multiple computing resources. Similarly, in microservices architecture, if a load to a particular backend microservice is getting increased, so it can be balanced using Eureka ribbon. So if we take an example, producer consumer application, if multiple consumer applications try to consume a single producer microservice, so in that case the producer services can be load balanced by deploying with the multiple instances. And how do this consumer application connect to the randomly created and available instances at the server? So here we will be registering the producer application, consumer application to the discovery server called Eureka, and then we will deploy with multiple instances of the producer, and we will be adding with the load balancer client at the consumer to connect to the any one of a microservice application. So this we will be looking into an example. Let's say in a simple producer consumer architecture based application, we will deploy one single producer instance and one single consumer instance, and we will have a collaboration between those two microservices. And these number of microservices are getting monitored by the Eureka discovery server. And coming here, when the load is getting increased for a particular producer application, so how do we balance it? This is what we are going to achieve with the ribbon. So at the consumer side, we need to add a dependency called load balancer ribbon, and then the producer instances must be created more than one, depends on the load, and we need to deploy it. And for every producer instance, a randomly generated ID is assigned so that the client can connect to one of an available producer service. So how do we achieve this? Practically, we will see the hands-on example. And in the producer application side, as usual, we will be configuring with the instance name and then a discovery server URL and the port number in which that particular service has to be executed. In addition to that, we need to add a new property as part of application.properties file or application.yml file called Eureka instance instance ID. If we provide with the Spring application name and random dat value, it is going to auto-generate a random instance value for every microservice. And in this particular example, we are going to start with two producer instances. So if a workload is getting increased, then we can also deploy more than two producer instances. And coming to, in a consumer application, we need to add with a new dependency called Spring Cloud Starter Ribbon. This we need to add it into a consumer application. And at the same time, in the consumer application, when you are going to consume it into your client application, instead of using with a discovery client, we are going to replace it with a load balancer client. We'll be creating with a reference of load balancer client, and you will provide with the producer instance name, and you will be getting an instance to receive and consume your application. This is what we will look into with the hands-on example. So here application is designed with one discovery server application, that is Eureka server application, where the Eureka server application is just enabled with enable Eureka server, and then we have added with the port number in which the Eureka is getting started with. Now first I am going to start with the Eureka server application. And this application is running on the port 8076. And for this particular discovery server, we need to register with the two microservices discovery client called consumer client and as well as the producer client. Okay, first let us look into the port number 8076 here. I am going to start with you can see here the Eureka console is just started with, and here there are no instances available. Now let us register the two instances, producer instance and as well as consumer. Before we deploy that producer application, let us look into the logic here. Just only we need to add with enable discovery client, and the producer application is going to be one simple employee controller where it will display the employee details. Just let me deploy this. Now as I said, in the application.properties file, you need to add a new property called instance ID. This will be auto-generated, random number is getting generated, and this you can observe. The employee discovery client is going to be registered with your discovery server. So if you observe here, there is no instance available. Okay. Now if you can see, employee producer is registered with a auto-generated random instance ID number. Now we would like to just test this microservice application with the individually with the port number 8079. So let me go here and check with 8079, and we will give the port the URL called employee. So it has to display the employee details. Just it is, we are testing that producer service whether it is deployed or not and whether it is executing or not. Done. One service is, one instance is deployed, so we could see here one instance which is running. Now let us say when we deploy the consumer application, so for consumer application, if too many clients are getting invoking the same service, we would like to deploy the more than one producer instance. So what do we need to do? We have to change the port number. You take it as 8078, a different port number, and deploy the producer application once again, so that we can have more than one producer instances available. So that if the load increases, any one of the instance can handle your client request. That is consumer application. Two producer instances are started here, and now we go to the Eureka admin console, and we will see here how many instances are running now. Two. The two instances, instance 1 and instance 2. This, why we are deploying more than one instance, is for load balancing purpose. Let us now deploy the consumer client. Consumer application is also one of a discovery client, so you need to enable with a discovery client here, and you can instead of invoking your services here with a simple discovery client, we will be using with load balancer client. The purpose of load balancer client is to invoke any one of available service on a server. If one is busy with, if it is heavily loaded, it automatically picks the other service which is already deployed with. That is the purpose of load balancer. So this is a load balancer is possible only when you are going to use with your dependency called Spring Cloud Starter Ribbon in your consumer application. It's not required in the producer application. It is only at the consumer side. Now I am going to deploy my consumer application. This is also is going to be one of a discovery client for your Eureka discovery server, that is Eureka Netflix. Now our consumer application is also deployed. You can observe the result is available here. And then if we go to the Eureka console, refresh, you can also observe here the consumer instance also. Still it is running. Still the instance is not generated. We will get the message at the console that the consumer instance is created. Yeah, now the consumer instance is ready. Now if you go here and check your instances available, you are able to see the consumer application. Now there is one consumer, two producers. If the load increases from your consumer side, any one of an available instance can handle with your request logic. This is the two instances. This is how we can achieve load balancing for our applications. This is one of a module from Spring Cloud to achieve a load balancing for microservices. That's all for this load balancing feature. Thank you.